So this session will be on the roles and role action mapping. Like this is about the access control, like screen wise all are allowed to access. So those details again, it will come from the MDMS.
Sorry, Malti. Actually, Omkar, can you add the Pradeep and other people using the Gmail ID?
Yeah, sure. I'll add them.
Thank you.
Malti, just give me a second, no?
Yeah. Moodley also wanted to join, but
okay.
Pingdom is not replying.
So Murli from our team is name?
Ah, Murli, our Egov Murli.
Okay.
I have pinged him in between. I think he'll join.
Sure.
So, others are there?
Vipin, who all do I need to add? I've added Pradeep. Vipin?
Omkar, Pradeep only. Shrikant, mail ID do you have?
No, if you can ping here, I'll add.
Okay.
I mean, I have some mail IDs. I don't know whose IDs there are.
Okay. Dede,
I've got his ID.
Okay.
Yeah, he joined. Shall we start?
Yeah. We can go to start, right? I've added both Pradeep and Srikant.
Yeah, if we can start. Actually, recording is also on.
Okay. So basically we have different types of users, employee and then citizen. Okay, so the employees will have again a set of roles. So through that roles, we will map that employee can have access to some set of actions, right? Not everyone will be allowed to do all the functionalities. So this mapping and the controlling, it is handled using role action mapping. So for each module, there will be a set of roles defined. And then for that module actions, we will do the mapping. And while creating an employee, we will assign a particular role to that employee. And when he logins, whatever the actions mapped to the role, which is mapped to that employee, will be available in the application. That is the thing behind this role action mapping. So basically, we have different set of users, like super user, HRMS admin, and then the normal users who perform the transaction. So the super user will have the super user credentials where he can see all the state level reports. And then HRMS admin is allowed to do only employee creation, edit employee, and employee user service related actions, okay? And the rest of the employees will be your transactional employees, like who are mapped to perform trade license or property tax creation, approval, and so on. So each module will have a different set of workflow. Workflow in the sense, levels. So trade license will have some three levels, like one person will create a trade license, the second person will verify it, third person will approve, and one more person will do the payment and final approval. So each person will have a different set of actions and a different set of roles. Okay, so when in case of property tax, it may not be the same number of levels, so it can vary. It can have some 2 levels or 3 levels. So each level, same employee can perform all the levels, or a different employee can do. So this is possible by assigning multiple roles to the same employee. Okay, so for trade license, we have like 4 levels. A counter employee can create an application. Document verifier does the verification, and approver will do the approval, and the collection again will be done by the counter employee only. So in trade license, we have these many roles: counter employee, doc verifier, approver, and then the again the same role, counter employee will do the collection. So module wise, there will be a different set of roles. But here we will not do that module wise segregation. If the same role can perform both TL and property tax, that is also allowed. If that role is only particular to trade license, the names will go by that module. Again, there is no fixed naming convention saying code should be like this only, name should be like this only. So it is left to the developer. For example, as I said, see TL counter employee, TL approver. So by name itself says it is for TL, trade license. Again, we have a citizen role, employee role, super user. So, and then GRO, this is grievance redressal officer, which comes for PGR module. And these are for TL. PGR admin. Again, there is one more counter employee. This is a general role. So again, in TL, we have TL counter employee. He is specific to TL. And this code should be unique. So under roles, master data, we have 3 parameters: code, name, and description. Code and name are mandatory. Okay, and this code should be unique. So whenever while creating an employee, it will go by the code, the mapping. So whenever you want to add new roles, you need to make an addition in this file. Otherwise, if you are using the existing role, that should be referred using this code. That mapping should be done using the code. So this is roles.json. And there is one more file called actions, action test. So this will hold the path of the actions. I will take trade license. So these actions are nothing but the endpoint. I'll show you. Trade license, search trade license. Navigation URL. So here, so the search trade license is one action. Okay, here we need to mention the mapping, which all roles can have a access to this action. All can make a search trade license. So this will be handled in this action role mapping. So before to that, we have to list out what all the actions that is available in our system under this file, action test.json, and what all the roles exist in our system in the roles.json, and the mapping between the roles and actions will be done in role action mapping. There is one more file called role action mapping. Sorry, role actions, which will define the mapping between the role and the action. So here it will have a link, the role code of the role which I shown in that roles.json, and this action ID will be the ID given for that particular action, and then tenant ID. Okay, so currently we not using this action code, we are doing the mapping by this only, action ID only. Okay, so this means super user can perform this particular action 628. So what is there in 628? Create tenant voucher status report. Sorry, 1628. This is so you can perform this action. So I'll take TL trade license counter employee CEMP. TL underscore CEMP 701. Action code is delete token. What is this? This is MDMS only, right? Referencing master. This is UAT. This is also UAT. Okay. So we'll see all users allowed to perform this trade license search. Yeah. So this action ID is 1690. This ID is not auto-generated, so it should be added in a sequence. In an order of, if you are adding a new action, it should be plus one of the last ID. 1690, this action is mapped to TL counter employee. That means all the employees who are mapped to this role, TL counter employee, will be allowed to perform this search trade license action. Similar way, this new means this is creation of license, trade license slash apply. Let's see, 1692 action ID. So again, this is mapped to TL counter employee, and it is not mapped to any other roles, TL approver or doc verifier. So this, for the doc verifier, what is the action mapped? Yes. So each role will have multiple mappings here. So he might not be doing only TL document verification. He will also be performing many other activities. So hence there will be many action IDs mapped for that role. But in action, it is a unique one. I'll go by this login only. If I log in as a doc verifier, and don't get confused with this username and this role name. So this is actually the employee name, which is not here for our easy sake. We have given the role name here. Okay. DL doc verifier. Okay.
Yeah.
So these are the set of applications which are come for verification with the document verifier. So I'm just trying to get the different actions. So they might have started restarting the service. Okay. So let me take this action. Okay, anyways, so I'll try after some time logging as a doc verifier. If they're restarting the service, sometimes it will not load. So this is where we keep the role action mapping, role code wise and then action wise. So each role can have multiple different actions mapping. So in action test JSON file, so this ID should be unique.
Is it the URL or navigational URL that is important in this file, action test?
Yes. Navigation URL is nothing but the URL of that action we actually add. So
okay,
if
there is one more attribute URL, right?
Yes.
What is the difference? I mean,
that is the base URL, I guess. Wait. This is given as URL. This URL stands for the internal URLs. Like for example, API to API call internally we might have. Okay. So
okay.
Those that will be defined here. This is the navigation URL is from the menu tree, whichever we use. That will come under the navigation URL. Okay, to fetch some data internally, we might have a service to service call. Okay.
Okay.
So that URL will be added here.
Okay, this is for internal calls.
Yes. And in that case, okay. It will be. So display name, get bill, enable false. See, this is TL calculator service. So in this case, there won't be any navigation. This will be used inside the calculation service. So in TL, we will be having some calculation. Based on the trade type, we have some rate calculation. So that calculation is part of, again, after doing a payment, we will be generating a bill. Many other things happens. And there will be a service to service call. So we will have, for TL, we have a two service. One is TL service, one is TL calculator service. Okay. So this URL will refer to the link of that API call.
Okay.
As such, in any of the clock, URL and navigational URL, both are not filled actually.
Yes.
Together as such.
Yes. So that means this navigation URL will be through the menu tree, which is directly accessible by the user.
Okay.
Okay. So this URL would be the internally called URLs.
And what is SSH path? Path is again in the menu wise trade application.
Yes. So under trade license application, if you go to home, trade license, this mapping, two levels of mapping.
So this is to verify the call or what?
So this API, whatever this trade license API, it is part of this path. Okay. Example, this is that path, like trade license. For example, this menu tree again will be loaded based on the actions. Okay. So here we have a card concept. So these cards are nothing but this menu tree items. Okay. So this will not have any actions mapped. These are just menu tree names, links which are provided for navigation. Okay. This will be added as a card inside action test.json. For example, if you see trade license, it is the display name. Okay. And this is the card. It is, the URL is a card. there are some set of convention, like for menu tree, what are the set of attributes to be set, and on click of that, whatever the actual last level menu tree items that get loaded are the one which are actually mapped for some certain actions. For example, here see, on click of trade license, I have trade license report, which is again a parent menu tree item, which has few more contents in it. So here, this is the last level in the menu tree. These last level items are mapped for certain actions. Okay, on click of receipt register, it is mapped for this action.
Okay.
And, but these are like clickable items. Okay, so these will be added as a card, and whatever the last hierarchy items are there, for that we will mention the path. This receipt register should come under trade license report. So this mapping we are doing in the
action test.
That action test, and in the there are different properties. To mention that, I will show you this search trade license. For example, if you take this, it has only one level. Trade license is a parent menu tree item. On click of that, we have search trade license. So here, this trade license is a card. It does not have any parent module. It is enabled. Enabled true means it should be shown in the menu tree. Okay. It does not have anything else. Okay. So here, directly left icon places business center.
So in this, it's mentioned like navigation URL is mentioned. So if you click on this, it's actually going to the different path. But
1 second. URL. Copy. 1 second. This is what you see, this is the complaint property tags. So navigation URL property tags. Finance. They make a trade license. Okay. Check on this. So this is basically, the path is empty and this is enabled true. Parent module is empty. It is the beginning of the link. So trade license. So it will have search trade license and the search trade license, how it is mapped. Okay.
By default, does it, when we click it, maybe it's mapped to that path?
Yes, I think so. Actually, this portion Mulli was supposed to join with the menu tree.
Okay.
Display name application, trade license. So, this is for that first level, trade license. So again, inside trade license, we have search trade license. So the other one is for that search trade license. Again, the search trade license also should be shown in the menu tray, right? The last level one.
Can you repeat it?
See, we have trade license.
Right.
Okay. As part of the menu tray. On click of trade license, we have search trade license. So two things which should be shown in the menu tray. Okay. So this is the first level. This is the second one. Wait, I'll show the first one.
First one is display name is application. So wherever the display name application is there, that is a root menu.
This is the root menu. And then the second one would be for the this would be for the search trade application. If you see, there is one more thing called trade license dot application as a path.
Right.
See, trade license dot application. This is for by defaultly what happens in citizen on click of trade license search trade license itself it will go to the search. I will log in as a citizen and I'll show you. So for that this is added by default navigation. So here in employee we have this two levels of hierarchy. So again, for search trade license, this should be enabled in the menu tray. This enabled is true in both the cases. So wherever we have an internal API call, the enabled would be false for it. So if you see trade license report, see here it has three levels of path. Trade license as the root one, TL reports as the second level hierarchy, trade license report. And the receipt register. So this path defines the menu tree path. Okay. And the navigation URL defines that actual action to be invoked on click of that. Okay. And this URL would be, we have a this reports won't come from the backend service. We have a separate configuration repository where all these reports will be written in an YAML file. Okay, there is a separate session on it. Okay, so this is the path of that actual, here for reports, there won't be any internal calls. So it is actually directly a YAML file invocation. So this will be covered, what is this URL and this thing in that reports, when the session happens for reports. Okay, this path is nothing but that menu tree path.
Is it
hello,
space separated, the path value that path value, is it separated by space or how is it?
It is separated by dots, not space.
Okay. Yeah. Trade license is a name of the one of the entity which is already, which is a parent entity, right?
Yes, it is a parent entity. Trade license report, and this receipt register.
Okay. And okay, can we find a trade license in the same file?
Yes,
somewhere
yes.
In the top.
Yes. Yes.
Not here,
it has to be the name, right?
It is again now. Let me check. It is the base. See, this application. It is the base path, I guess. And somewhere it is missing out. Okay. We'll do one thing. This I will verify and then I will clarify in tomorrow's session during localization. Is that fine?
Yeah, fine. No problem. Huh? Yeah, sure, because
the other person was supposed to join. So I will... what is actually these entities means... That in detail, I will explain it in tomorrow's session. But this mapping, this levels of mapping will be maintained in this file only, action file only. That is clear. Okay.
Okay. Okay.
So other two files are fine, right? Roles.json and then roleaction.json.
Yeah, it's clear.
It's clear, right? Now through how can we map roles to employees, I will just explain. So initially, when we create one, when we do a configuration for one fresh state, so that point of time, what we will do, we will create two employees through backend, means through REST API. One is super user, and then one is HRMS admin. Okay. So post to that only, using those two employees login, we will create other normal employees. So super user and HRMS admin will not be created via this application. This is to be noted. Whenever we are setting up an environment for any particular state, so these two base employees will be created using the REST endpoint. There is a create employee, create no validate employee API. So we use that API and create these two employees. So then we use them to create further other module specific employees. This is clear?
Yes. Super user is one of the employee, and which is other employee?
HRMS admin.
Okay.
HRMS is human resource management system. So who is involved in creating employees, editing the employee details, everything related. Okay.
Okay.
EMP2. Umkar, you know the HRMS admin credentials for UAT?
Yes, Malati, let me pick them.
EMP4,
yeah, I think.
Yeah, got it.
Yeah.
While creating this employee, we will map the HRMS admin role. Okay, so he will have access to employee creations. He can search, edit, and then add employees. See here, ULB wise employees we can search. See for role key, these many employees with these many roles are created. TL counter employee. See here, we can see employee can be mapped to multiple roles. So this counter employee is mapped, for example, PT data creator role key has mapped to two roles, data entry admin, so and so. So in this designation department, this is the common data, which is same for all the ULBs and all modules. See, when we add employee, it will ask for which ULB we need to create that. So here we will provide the basic employee details, professional details. So here we will say what is the role of that employee, whether it is a super user, TL counter, TL approver. So we have many roles related to PT. So I will say this. See, we can have a number of roles as well. So in the employee screen, while creating, you can add many roles. So for editing, search, TL doc verifier. So here, if you want to edit details, edit. If you want to deactivate that employee, in case of this, that employee will not be able to do any of the further actions if we deactivate. In case of edit, his base assigned role will be displayed. So here either you can change his role or add few more roles in edit employee screen. So this is where the roles will be shown. In the search employee screen or the create employee. Other than this, nowhere else we will be able to see the role value. So this is clear?
Malti, the roles are fixed, right? Right now, or we can add more roles? Or
you can add, it is not fixed. So whatever the values here it comes will be populated from that roles.json. If you want to add more roles, it should be added in the roles.json. And it should be unique. The code should be unique. Code and name.
Okay.
Okay. So whenever you make changes to the MDMS, make sure the MDMS service will be restarted. Then only your changes will be reflected. Okay. And n number of roles. And whenever you write a new code or a new set of API. Okay, so that action should be added in the action test JSON. Here in this file. And then whether who can be able to access, perform that new action, that mapping you need to add it here, role action mapping. Okay.
So we need to define the complete path. Okay, he can access this, for example, trade related application, then he can do this. All that mapping has to be defined. We cannot inherit someone's role, okay, it having this extra capability. Like that, we cannot define, right?
In the extra capability, in the sense?
Means, for example, this we are having the counter employee, right? So, extending the counter employee function means capability, whatever the features he have, whatever the role. Functionality action he can do plus something.
That also you can mention. Like if you want a TL counter employee to be allowed to make a property tax creation, then what you will do, you will assign that property tax PT role for that employee.
Okay, you will assign two roles.
Two roles. He will have multiple roles. Yes. Okay. That is what I shown here. Here, employee, this particular employee, he can do verification as well as he can do approval of TL. If you want cross module access, so he can does a finance voucher creation, he can do PT creation. PT counter employee is allowed to create a property tax. So now we are assigning these many roles to this user, means he can perform trade license, financials and property tax, all three. So in this case, all three modules will be enabled in his inbox.
Okay.
And role versus functionality mapping, can that also be edited? I mean, role can two or three actions that also can be extended or
No, it can be extended. I said no, like in action test, it should be unique. same action cannot be repeated. But in role action,
okay, we will add another role action
yes
object, right?
Yes, this action ID and role code combination should be unique. Like I cannot say 629 against super user one more
okay,
time.
Okay, correct. Okay.
Yeah. So you can have 629 to financial administrator.
Yeah, yeah.
This role code and action ID together should be unique.
Okay.
Okay. So while adding, should be careful, like any one small syntax error, if we forget to insert the comma and we added, we restarted MDMS service, it will not reflect. And since this is a JSON file, the whole MDMS data will not load. In the screen, drop downs may not be loaded. So in that case, it will be something related to, you need to guess that it will be something related to JSON file. If it is recently committed, you just verify, is there any syntax error? Better to copy this JSON and do a validate in this. There are online tools where you can format and then validate your JSON. So we usually do this. Whatever newly added changes, if you paste and say validate, it will validate. If there are any errors, it will show up here. And then you can commit.
And one more thing, while adding the new action ID, I can see that if you see there, it is 1889 and the other one is 18988. Is it ordered in ascending order or some order is there, or how do we get the maximum value if I have to add a new entry to it?
So actually, it is ordering in a sequence, it should be. Sometimes what happens if some functionalities are removed, if some actions are taken out, they're deleting okay. it. So in between, the sequence might have missed. But usually we follow the sequence and ID okay. should be unique.
Okay, then we have to scroll down to the last entry and do plus one.
Plus one, yes.
Okay.
In the role actions, actually, the tenant ID is there. So do we have anything ULB specific also, or it will always be U means state tenant ID only? It will be constant, right, for all the
It will be constant because the service remains same for state, right? The TL service, whatever the coding we do and the endpoint, it remains same,
right?
So it is a constant.
So, but there is no like in every block, right? But still we need to write for each and every block.
It doesn't make any sense keeping tenant ID UK because we are adding for UK only. If you do not add, we need to verify that. Okay. I'm not sure whether this is a mandatory or non-mandatory, but it does not add any value for this role action. There is no ULB specific action IDs.
Okay.
Maybe the purpose of keeping this tenant ID, maybe in future to support ULB specific also, I guess.
Okay. An action code, previously it was used, now it's not used, or in future again, this action code part?
Here in the action item, we have two things, ID and then code, which both are again unique ones. Okay. So here we map role to action using the unique IDs. Since here we are using ID, this is kept blank. This is of no use. Either you can map to code also. But in the as a so practice, we are using it for ID.
So action code is we can remove it or?
We can remove it.
Okay.
So screen wise, if you see counter employee, and this is related to HRMS user. So I will log in as super user and see. So this is the base tenant. So I can't say EMP3 super choose any city. While creating this user, I have chosen is base tenant would be Aldwani. So I'm using that. As I said, super user will have access to state level reports. So these actions mapping will be done for super user role in the action. This loading of the menu tree will be done from this action test JSON. The list of menu tree items and plus the role action mapping. So it will see for this logged in user, what is the role? The role is super user. And for that super user, what all the actions are mapped? These three things will be verified against this action test.json and then the role action.json, and these will be populated. So basically for super user, only reports will be enabled, all the state level reports and module wise reports. So you can see in each module only reports are enabled for trade license report, property tax report, and then so demand bill, again some reports related to billing service. So super user also assigned with HRMS admin role, so he'll be able to create employees also. So if this option is coming, add employee means this user is again mapped with HRMS admin role. Okay. So I can see this employee 3. I will show you here only. Employee 3 super search.
Is it name or ID?
I think
this name, I don't think underscore will be.
So let me see for counter employee.
Malati, did you cover the navigation URL part?
Partially I covered. There are a few queries that I said I will cover it in tomorrow's session during the localization.
Okay.
So this particular user is mapped with HRMS admin role as well as the super user role. So why this, maybe I'm trying with the wrong name, I guess.
Touch upon the multi-tenancy also, Malati. Like different places we can have different rooms.
Yeah. Okay, so as I said, this counter employee is mapped to perform property tax also and then trade license also. You can see he is with multiple roles, I mean across module roles. Elsan, this multi-tenancy thing is not merged. Yeah. I'll just explain. So we have one more.
Yeah, Malati, you can just explain, and tomorrow we can go from the micro dev.
Okay. So there is one more feature called multi-tenancy. In that sense, one employee can be mapped to multiple tenants. So now I showed like edit profile. If you see, you can see this user is mapped to only Haldwani. That means he can perform transactions only for this ULB. So with the help of multi-tenancy feature, he can be accessible, he can be allowed to perform transaction across multiple tenants. So one employee can have mapping to n number of ULBs. So that is what the meaning of multi-tenancy. So that feature is not enabled in this environment. So tomorrow I'll show up in a different environment where that is enabled. Guys, clear on this concept?
So other than role, we will be having option to select the ULBs. Right.
Yes. Yes. He'll be mapped to like how we are allowing mapping of n number of roles for one employee. Similar way, he'll be having mapping to n number of tenants.
Which citizen service will have this kind of requirement?
Multi-tenancy smaller ULBs. What happens is like tax collectors and all. Like they will have to work across ULBs. Probably there will be like two ULBs handled by one guy, and in one ULB he may go as a field inspector, and another probably he'll sit in office and do some work. So in smaller ULBs, these kind of things we have seen.
Okay, they are dividing like that ULBs. At least they can merge the ULBs itself, right?
No, their jurisdiction boundary will be different. So merging won't be possible, but like they one person will be assigned to work across ULBs. Because we have seen in Andhra Pradesh also like these kind of use cases. Like 4 or 5 ULBs is assigned to one guy to do some work. But he will have a primary ULB where he is having some primary role. Okay. Over and above that, he will do something else also. So they may be under deputation from somewhere else, those kind of people.
Okay. So one primary application of this is employees who have a district-wide role. So for example, one employee can have the role of maybe supervisor or administrator across ULBs in, let's say, Bangalore district. So there are like 4 or 5 ULBs across the district. So that employee will be that employee will be mapped against all the ULBs as part of that district. So that is one of the prime use cases. So in Uttarakhand, we have these zonal or nodal officers who work across districts or zones. So zones in Punjab and in Uttarakhand, they're across districts. So they are kind of enabled in multiple ULBs.
So mandatorily, they should be mapped to one primary ULB.
Correct.
Okay. So in today's, we covered how to add roles, how to add actions, and then mapping between roles and actions, and a few doubts with respect to that navigation URL. I'll be covering it in tomorrow's session, along with this multi-tenancy feature.
Okay.
Guys, any other doubts with respect to this?
One is module specific name, that TL is for that part also.
Okay. That is noted.
And MDMS na, default folder, in that role actions is there. In that two files are there. Role actions and role action. So what is the difference as such? In playground MDMS. Not in
playground.
Yeah.
It is not same as this. Actually, this will be used, roleactions.json.
No, why are this? Malati, default is not the right place to see. You have to go under PG.
PG only.
Default is actually not required. So there will be one tenant. So for Bihar, it would be BH. For playground, right. We have named it as PG. Just okay. A notation, that's all. So there it's like a dummy state and a city. So we have defined it as pg.cityA, pg.cityB, cityC, like that. Okay. In Uttarakhand, you will say UK, UK dot and the proper name. So default, don't see default. Default is actually not used.
Maybe okay. Before adding this PG, they have added default.
But this is the right place, which we are okay. Seeing. Yeah, it's the right place.
Yeah. So here it has only role actions.json. So how many ever files will be there? The referred file will be with this name, roleactions.json.
Okay.
And then as I said, in the MDMS repository, the mandatory files and folders would be these many. These three, tenant and the common masters. So all others would be added based on the modules we are enabling and then the cities.
Okay. So ideally, we won't be modifying this file, right? Until as we are not defining our own custom application and all that.
Yes. That's what MDMS master data, it stands for. Like it won't be frequently edited. It is one-time defined data.
I'm saying for the role actions and role part. Obviously, other field will be other. Folder we have to modify.
Yeah. If you are adding a new role, you have to know.
Okay.
Right. If you are creating any new feature, then those actions, if you are mapping for existing roles, the existing roles would be the same. If you are adding a new role and a new action, obviously in that case, you need to edit all these files.
Okay. So, because if that is the case, I will be adding my actions and this code in this repository will also be getting updated. So
yes.
Means when we are updating it, do we have to follow some number after that only we should start, or the last number only we should start doing that? For example, 2000, I am also using it, and in your you are also using it. When we merge the code, then it will be
then that will give a conflict. It won't give conflict, but it will not refer the proper action.
Right.
Always the ID should be unique. Okay.
Let me take
for the merging part. I'm saying.
Yeah. I have a point to add there. So every environment will have their own MDMS repo, separate repo. So for cantonment board, you will have to create a separate repo, and all the masters related to that will be maintained. So this can be a private repo. It need not be public also. So this merge. So within your team, if 4 or 5 developers are using the same file at the same time, only this kind of conflict will come. That has to be reviewed. So we generally do a pull request, and there is a reviewer who will review and then merge. So I will propose the same to be followed at your end also.
Okay.
You are pointing to the second point, right? Within the team, if many are adding up the actions with the same ID.
That is also there, and between our team and your team, like because you will be updating the same act, you will be adding the actions into.
We will not be touching any. This is for the state. So playground MDMS is for some playground state. Bihar MDMS is for Bihar state. So ego will not be touching any data related to that.
Okay. So whenever you add a new actions, okay. So.
So we will be giving our product MDMS data to you. You can take that and create a cantonment board MDMS repo.
Okay.
You can pick and choose whichever masters you want, not all masters. So if you're taking only trade license related and the basic infrastructure related master data, you need to add in the cantonment board repo.
Okay.
So that's a new repo by itself, which you are only you are managing. Don't even give access to ego team.
Okay.
If the conflict happens within the team, as Elzan said, with the PR review, it will be resolved. Otherwise, again, manually you have to go through the data and then properize the ID. Usually IDs will be unique. The what is the latest maximum plus one will be preferred.
Okay.
Anything else?
Hi, Malti. This creation of super user and HRMS admin, you told that it will be created using the REST endpoint. So are you going to show that, or is it outside the scope of this presentation? Like what all, like what all attributes has to be passed and how the data body is.
So this is the basic details. It's employee tenant ID, the employee status, but whatever the data we provide through application, the same has to be provided here.
And so the name. And if we, sorry to interrupt, and if we are using like, so we have to follow the same data structure to create a super user as well as an HRMS, this thing, right?
The employee creation is same. Super user and state admin is a role. Okay.
Right. Yeah.
So the structure will not change role wise. It will remain same. Employee creation API request will be same. Only the role mapping you have to do based on that, whether he is a super user or an admin.
Okay. So for all the endpoints, you will have API contracts defined in the Git. You can refer that, and Postman collections are also there for samples. You can refer that.
And one more doubt is just a functionality related doubt. Suppose if you delete any employee or deactivate his role, so what will happen to the request which he was already catering? So those requests will be redirected to someone, no problem.
So actually what happens in our application, so it will be available in everyone's inbox with that role. Okay. So if that particular employee gets deactivated, so other employee with that role will be allowed to continue the flow.
Okay. So if with one role, there are two employees, so all the tasks will be shared among them. Like they can see all the tasks which are there under that particular role.
Essential
ones. Yeah, Malti, that will be covered as part of the workflow service session.
So that that session will answer your question. But basically, the other persons with that same role will have access.
Okay.
So each role employee will have two things. Like one is actually assigned to him, and all other applications. Which are available for that role. So this section will be covered in that workflow session.
Okay.
Yeah.
And the documentation related to this, in the browser, if you go to the fifth tab, is it the right place to find the documentation?
Browser?
Yeah, tab. In the browser, yeah.
This is for MDMS. This is a Confluence link. So I'll share if you want for that roles related.
Okay, that contract related information regarding the APIs.
That will be there in Git repo as part of the code base.
Okay.
So whichever code, I think master you will be referring to, right? So it will be in that.
So it will be part of that repositories only. This is for TL if you want to see. Anyways, I'll share all those details in the mail. Let's see. Where is exactly that contract will be defined?
So that will be need service, Manji. Need service will have its own contracts. So just go through each contract will be there in that service only. One dot by YAML file you can see. So that will define the, so Postman will have all the sample collections. Now you can give a sample link later.
Yeah, yeah.
The same structure followed in other services also. If you are fine, we can close today and then continue tomorrow at 11. Malti only will be taking.
Tomorrow's will be on the localization part, how we support multiple languages across all modules. Along with that, I will be today's questions, few questions, I'll answer it tomorrow.
Okay.
Malti?
Ha, Divya. Hello.
Malti, in our Excel, we have the thing like how to configure. I'm telling about the 2 o'clock wala session.
Okay, till
2 o'clock session. In that, as per our Excel, we have the thing like how the MDMS work, how to configure the tenant. That will be adding a new tenant to our tenant.json.
Yes.
Yeah, and the next one is how to configure product X. What is that thing?
That is nothing but module. I explained, right, how to enable a module, each ULB specific. Product in the nothing but a module, like trade license.
Okay, that is the module. Okay. Yes. Okay, Madhu, thank you.
If no questions, shall we wind up?
Yes.
Thanks, guys. See you tomorrow at 11.
Thanks. Can you please share this recording?
I have already added one recording to GitHub, Vipin. I'll also add this recording also to that.
Yesterday's first half, we are still doing that edit. It will be shared tomorrow.
Share it in 1-2 days. It needs